What's up, guys? My name is Pony Lawson, and I'm a tattooer from Chicago, Illinois, and I've been tattooing for 20 years. I've had a lot of tattooers reach out to me lately and ask what kind of new techniques they can add to their arsenal, what kind of little secrets or tips that they could use to further their work. I'm not going to sugarcoat anything. I'm going to give you an honest opinion as I can. Whether that's good, bad, or indifferent, I want these to be as honest as possible. Again, these are only my opinions. Take it with a grain of salt. You can write me some hate mail if you want. I'll just keep it in the spam folder. That being said, let's get into it. All right, so first up we have this lighthouse from Barry Welsh. What's up, Barry? Right away, I can see this is a pretty big tattoo. I'd say the first thing that stands out to me is the background in the clouds. It kind of looks like a muddy mess, for lack of better words. I feel like it being a lighthouse, there should be some clear light coming out of it. It just kind of looks like dark clouds surrounding a lighthouse that isn't in use. The problem that you're having here is there's too much shading up next to the lighthouse itself when there should be light beams coming from it. There should be no shading where the light is coming out from the house itself. The shading needs to be around the light to make it look like it's illuminating. But since there's shading up next to it, it makes it look like the lights are off. And it's a lighthouse, right? The other thing is, it's a lot of wasted space up top. And I'm sorry to keep ragging on the top here, but it's a lot of space. It's a lot of wasted space. I wish I would have seen that done differently. And unfortunately, I don't know if there's a way to salvage the light because the shading's already there. I mean, if I had access to a laser, I would laser some of that to get rid of it and then reshape those values. But the lighthouse itself is shaded well. It's very clear, and you can tell which side the light is coming from with the white highlight being there. I like how you've got the name Noah hidden in this boat down at the bottom. It's not in your face, but it is there. However, I'm just very distracted by the overall lack of light coming from the lighthouse. I'm just shocked it's a lighthouse with no lights on. But you did send another one. Let's get over to that one real quick so I don't feel so bad. I like these praying hands a little more than what you've did with a lighthouse. I feel like you're in control more with the shading in these hands. I can tell where veins are running through the hands. I can tell where shadows sit. And I like the light rays in the background. They're very strong and bold. However, if we come down here to the bottom where these clouds are, again, I feel like clouds are your weak point. I don't know if you did these clouds first or last, but I think they're taking advantage of you, and I don't think you're giving the clouds enough proper attention. They don't fit the style, first of all. You've got these realistic hands, you've got these light rays coming out of the back, and then you've got these very cheesy 90s clouds that you see on all the rappers back in the day. It kind of feels like a cop-out, and I wish they weren't there. I'm sorry that's a bit harsh, but I think you should spend your time working on realistic clouds. I think that would really elevate your work to the next level. Because your work is beautiful. You have the praying hands themselves are great. And the lighthouse itself is a good tattoo as well. There's just too much distraction in the clouds and the backgrounds. The backgrounds are always just as important as the foreground. If you cop out on the background, it's gonna cheapen the foreground. I hope that wasn't too mean, but again, that's my honest opinion. Your shading is nice. The big fields of area, if we go back to the lighthouse, the shades themselves are very nice. You know how to handle the machine. I just think you need to take your time and work on the structure of the design itself. But yeah, thank you for sending that over, Barry. I appreciate it. Next up, we have Omri Amar. Omri sent in a General Grievous color portrait that looks pretty dope. Let's see, I'm gonna have to zoom in on this one. I would say, if you were to give some sort of outline, whether that be a 3-round liner outline or a 5-round liner outline, some sort of barely there outline on the front of his face and on these, I don't know what you'd call those, on those front pieces of metal, I feel like you would really give some depth of field there. You would really make it seem like the face is popping forward out of the entire background. And you wouldn't even notice those outlines, especially if it's a 3-round liner, maybe not quite solid black, but an almost black wash. Run that straight through. I promise you, you won't see the line, and shade from that, and you'll really get a nice pop from the entire front. Both those little metal pieces that are coming out from around his mouth and grill and his right eye all the way up to the top. Leave the background how it is, and I promise you, it'll make it seem like it's popping forward that much more. One more thing, at the top, I feel like maybe there could be a little more shading, maybe a little more darkness. I think if you added a little more dark blue on top of the head, it would illuminate this a bit more. You could even add more dark blues, dark purples, dark slates to the back of the head where it's transitioning into the back, this little shadow right here up top. But I do think if you had a darker background up top, you know, maybe even some, you know, black space or something like that, it would look really sharp, and it would really help this head look like it's popping forward. I don't have anything else negative to say. I think these are just small improvements that you could make to help elevate your work. But other than that, the shading looks good. I like your color choices. I do see a couple areas in here. The white highlights seem a little scratchy, which is okay. He's beat up metal, so it's working well for you. But if I had to break them down, I feel like this little white highlight in front is just a little scratchy and not as clean as it could be. All right, Omri, thank you for sending that in. I appreciate it. So there's just not a whole lot to say. I think you did a good job on this one. Just small improvements, and yeah, thank you. Next up, we have Tyler Grady. What's up, Tyler? And you sent in a black and white cardinal. So right away, my eye goes to the front of this beak, which I'm sure yours does too. It's a very thick front beak, a little thicker than the rest of the bird. However, I think you could still make this work if you were to thicken up the entire bird with this thick of an outline around the entire thing. Not the leaves in the back and not the branch, but I think if you were to thicken up the entire outline and match it with what you have in the front, I think you'd have some nice line weights there. Not the outlines on the inside of the bird, not the inside of the wing, but just the outside outline. I think if you were to thicken that up, I think that would help out a lot, and it would also stand out against those flowers in the back and the branch. Another thing is that this whole bird looks like it's been done with a standard shading method, but it seems like this area in here, this wing, seems like it's almost opaque gray. And I don't know if that's just because you added white to your wash and then made a full saturation of that wash, but it seems like the entire bird is done with gray wash and then the wing is with white wash. I don't know why that is. It just seems like it's a little too full saturated in that wing. But other than that, I'd say maybe you can add some other elements too to make it pop, right? Something else in the background to give it some more life. And I know it's black and white, so you're limited on what kind of colors you can bring to the table. But I think just something in the back, something nice washed out in the back would be nice. It just seems like it's a basic tattoo. Yeah, I don't know what else to say about that. Thanks, Tyler. I appreciate you sending that in. So let's see here. Let's see which one I'm going to grab. All right, I'm going to go after this Frida. Oh, I'm going to go after you, boy. Mm-hmm. Next up, we have Crystal Trevino. Mm-hmm. Crystal sent in a Frida portrait.
Frida, I'm going to get you, girl.
This will be fun to tear apart. Okay, so you sent in the reference as well, which is nice, so I can kind of see these side by side. Right away, I would say add more black in the background. It would really help illuminate the face. The more darks you have in the background, the more light the face can appear. I think the main issue here is just a lack of black in the background. It just seems like you put in enough just to illuminate the face, and that's clear. If you were to brush out the rest of that shading, meet the other tattoo, fill in the rest of that area, and it'll really seem like that face is sitting in the shadows, which it is. That is part of why that photo was so dramatic. You know, because of the darkness that surrounds it, not just her face. The same thing could be said for the back of the tattoo up into the hair. The shading is nice, the direction is nice of the hair, but I feel like there's just not enough black going on. Even dark shading, not solid black, but even like an 80-90% black. One last thing, the shading in the face. On the reference, there's not really many ultimate white spots, and by ultimate white, I mean white as paper. The only time I leave white in a tattoo is if it's as white as the paper. If I were to print out a reference on a piece of paper, if it's not paper white, I don't leave it skin tone. If it's any sort of shade on the paper, I shade it on the tattoo. To me, it looks like this entire face is shaded. When I go to the tattoo, there's a lot of open skin, which can be fine, but it's just not how I would do things. I would take the time and very gently, softly, slowly, pendulum stroke in some nice shades into this face using a very light wash. The slower you move those lighter washes, the easier they go in, believe it or not. And I really do think that this just needs a little shade to bring down the luminosity of this face. It's just a bit too bright. So overall, more shades. Don't be afraid to spend more time on a tattoo. Take the time it needs, give it the attention it needs. Not that you did the bare minimum, but on some parts you only did enough work to make the other parts work. Give it all the attention it needs. Put the background in there, spend time putting all the black where it needs, outlining each petal, how it needs to be outlined. The fingers should all have some sort of outline on them, whether that's an actual outline or a shade. If you had shading in the face, the side of that pinky would illuminate. There needs to be dark where there is light in everything. That's how it works. So you can't have two lights next to each other. But I can see the potential here. I just think you need to give it more time. Give it the time it needs. Don't rush. But thank you for sending that in, Crystal. I appreciate it. All right, next up we have Jordan LeClaire. Jordan sent in a Wednesday Addams from the Addams Family. Definitely an all-time classic and an iconic image. So you can't really go wrong. you can go wrong. But you didn't. You did a good job on this tattoo. I'm super rad. Right away, I love this tattoo. It's a sweet reference, a great movie. If I had to give you any constructive criticism, I would say get rid of the bats or make them more relevant or bring something else in the background with them to where they're not just hanging off on the side. It's the one and only thing that I feel like is just hanging out there that necessarily shouldn't be. I know you probably wanted to bring another element to the tattoo besides the picture. It just feels like you only committed 20% to that. Do some other stuff, you know, maybe add their house in the back, you know, fill up that room, or don't put those bats in there at all. I think it would have been a little bit cleaner had those not been there, but you still have the opportunity to add other things as well. Now let's get into the shading. I can tell you know what you're doing by the needle strokes and which way they're facing. So you're shading the right way, you're pushing the right way, you're 90% there. If I had to change anything about this, it would be bust out a liner, whether that be a 3-liner or a 5-liner. Really give some nice shape to the fingers, to the bottle, under the chin, you know, where those heavy shadows are. If you're just using a mag, sometimes those can fall a little soft. When you use a liner, things tend to stick out a bit more. So you use that to your advantage when something's in front. The fingers that are in front, the bottle that she's drinking from, those need to be in the foreground. So try and experiment with those liners. It can't hurt. Get out a little gray wash and outline the entire thing. I promise you, you're gonna like the results. For those of you who aren't artists that aren't aware, when I say things like 5-liner, 9-liner, that's just the diameter. It's just the thickness of the needle. So if I'm talking about a liner, 9s, 14s are going to be a little bit thicker, and the smaller ones will be 3s and 5s. It's just the amount of needles they have in there, so it just determines the thickness of the line. One other thing, if we had to go back to her eyes, and I know you probably saw this as well, it looks like her left eye is a little more open than the right eye, but again, that's nothing that like a small liner going really slowly can't fix. If you're able to go back one more time on this tattoo, just add a few more things in the background, tidy up a couple things with a liner, and you've got a home run. Good job, Jordan. So next we have Heart Casket. They sent in a couple portraits that they want me to make better. Well, I can't tattoo it for you, but I can tell you what you can do to improve. Because I had the same issue several years back. Mine looked a lot like this. People would describe my stuff as painterly, and it kind of drove me crazy. I wasn't going for painterly, I was going for realistic, right? How I fixed that was essentially just slowing down. When I noticed my stuff was too painterly was when I was trying to get too much stuff done at once, and I had to kind of speed through everything to get it done. I'm looking at this first tattoo you sent over of the couple looking at each other, about ready to make out. If somebody were to come to me for this tattoo, I would have probably done it in 2 sessions. That way I could have given the proper amount of time to each one. The lady in itself looks like she could have taken about 4+ hours, and he could have easily taken 5 or 6 hours. Not that that couldn't all be done in 1 session, but I think if you were to break that up in 2, you could not have that rushed feeling in the back of your brain that you need to complete this big task in 1 go. Another thing you could do to help remedy the painterly issue is to maybe use round liners a little more. Break out a 9-liner, a 14-liner, maybe some smaller ones, and use those as your shading. Because right now I can tell that you're using your mag a lot, maybe for everything. I really don't see much liner work, maybe in the eyelids and a little piece in the ear. Real photographs have a lot of imperfections. You know, there's these people's faces are very smooth. Nobody's face is that smooth in real life. It's the little things to put in there, little moles, little bumps, little dots here and there, a little stubble on the face, something. Those little tiny things can make a huge difference. I think this is a good first session, what you have here. I think you can go on top of this and improve a lot more. You can go into the white shades that are in front of the forehead, same thing with the cheek and things like that. You know, give it some more organic shape to help it feel realistic. When you do that, you'll feel more confident in your work from there on, and you'll be a little more comfortable taking that further with every tattoo. So my main takeaways, slow down, maybe divide the session into 2, and use round liners a little more. I think that'll help elevate your work. You sent in another one that I'm gonna take a peek at real quick. These strawberries here. If you want to make these strawberries look as realistic as you can, I think that the back strawberry is fantastic. However, not really anything in real life has this white outline on it like these do. So the white outline around the entire strawberry is immediately flattening it. It's turning into a sticker. The other thing that's holding you back from making this look realistic is the little flower and the leaves behind it. They look too much like stickers. They look like a cartoon. There's not many leaves in real life that look that vibrant, especially when they're sitting in the background. You know, add some more dark greens and get rid of all those whites. The blue background also isn't helping, especially with the little shades of dots. It's really turning this more into an illustrated piece. And if you're going for realistic, these are the things that I would do different. If you're going for illustrative, then I think you're on the right path. but you're asking me what you can do to get rid of this painterly effect. So these are what I would do. Like I said, the rear strawberry looks great. The coloring that you have on there is great. It looks very real. Get rid of the white. And if you're going to outline things like this flower here, which I'm a fan of, I like the outlines on it, but you need to have some sort of shading pushing away from those to help mask the outline, give the impression that it's a real petal or a real leaf. Again, taking a little more time on these would help out tremendously. When you think the tattoo is done, let it sit for a few minutes, go back on top of it. You can add some more detail in this front strawberry, and same thing with the leaves in the background. There could just be more detail. Your tattoos as a whole can just use more detail. That's what's gonna make it look more realistic. All right, Hart, thank you so much for sending those in. I hope that helps you in any sort of way. Let me know. I appreciate you, thank you. Next up we have Sora Vereth from Italy. And I hope I said that right. Sora sent in three or four tattoos. This first one we're looking at, I'm gonna look at the tiger. A beautiful work, by the way. I like how you have the hand in the photo for the reference so you can see exactly how big this is. That's something I think a lot more people should do, just so you can get a size reference. It's nice, you know. That being said, really beautiful tiger. Good job on this. Good job on needle control and putting everything where it needs to be. You have good contrast, good lighting. If I had to give you any sort of critique about this, I'd say you could control your whites a little more. The shading, I think you've got down for the most part. You're 85-90% there. I think with where you're deciding to put the white, you could just punch it in a little bit more. It seems like it's just barely there, right? Like in the nose, in the muzzle, and in the eyes. I think if you were to stick that needle out a little bit further, and just really push it in there, those eyes would pop out so much more. Another thing I could say is using that three liner or single liner. I don't personally use single liners a lot. I feel like they make the skin a little too red. I get better luck with a Bug Pin 3, whatever works for you. But whatever small liner you're using, adding some more of that texture in there that you have on the middle of the muzzle here, bringing it down to the nose and to the side, bringing all that texture in the front of the muzzle so it looks like it's coming out of the face. And the back is fine. You don't need those small hair details in the back because that's what's gonna give us that depth of field. Yeah, a few more little of those detail lines on the front muzzle, I think that would really help push that along. And then maybe in this rear ear here, his left ear, I think you could use a little more detailing as far as the ear fuzz go and things like that. I think it just gets a little too soft back there. I think that can use some crispening. Another one you sent over is this leopard. And again, great work. I think you can benefit a little bit more from shading with your liner as opposed to just outlining it and adding the black dot. I feel like it's just lacking shading in the body as a whole. It looks like a great tattoo, but as I zoom in and get up close to it, there's just parts around it that could use more definite shading. Where the hind leg meets the body, it just seems like it's almost flat. From the stomach to the leg is almost flat. If you could bring that liner up and just give that a little more definition, I think it would help set the leg in front of the body. Same thing with the front leg. You almost had it, the back of the front leg, there's the outline that comes around the elbow there. Same thing with the front paw on the far side. There needs to be some sort of lining or some sort of shading from the chest to make it look like the chest is sitting in front of that leg. To me, overall, good looking tattoo, could use a little more work on definition. But thank you, Sora. All right, next up we have Saba. I'm not even gonna pronounce your last name. Merbaha, I did it. You sent over a Stanley portrait that you did on yourself and you've only been tattooing for 6 months. Pretty impressed. If I were judging this tattoo on somebody that's been tattooing for 20 years, you know, I'd have a lot more to say about it, but you've only been tattooing 6 months, so I'm pretty impressed with this. But as this sits right now, this is a solid tattoo, and I like that you did it in, I'm assuming, all in a liner. Maybe you did the glasses in a mag, but it looks like you did most everything in a liner, which is great, I think. So that being said, this is gonna stick around for a while. Sometimes mag shades don't stay as long as liner shades do as stipple work. I'm happy to see that you did it that way. One thing that does stand out to me is his nose. I feel like you might have gotten a little carried away on the shading on his nose because it seems a little concave. Not really something you could do to remedy that, but just something to watch out for in the future. Maybe slow down a little bit and make sure that doesn't happen. Little white highlights are places that they necessarily don't need to be, like little parts in the hair and stuff like that. They don't need to be there, especially the ones that I see up here. Probably aren't gonna stick around for more than a few years, if that. So don't bother putting them in there. You don't really need him on his left part of his nostril. It doesn't need to be there. Usually what I do with my white highlights, I try to stick to things that have an obvious reflective surface, like metal or water. Another thing is, if I'm going to introduce white into a face at all, then you have to do the entire thing. If you're gonna put white in the forehead at all, then you have to put white in the cheeks, the nose, the lips, the teeth, everywhere, or it's not gonna look right. In this case, I would have not put any white in anywhere on the skin. I would have only kept it in the glasses. And that's probably about it. But other than that, you don't really need it in the face. You don't really need it in the mustache or the hair. It's unnecessary. But exceptional job nonetheless, especially this being on yourself. I'm excited to see where you go in the future. You know, I'm excited to see, you know, 3, 4, 5 years from now, where you're at in your career. Maybe send me some stuff in another few months and let me critique it again. Thank you, Zaba. I appreciate it. What's up, Sia? Thank you for sending me your work. This is an absolutely clean tattoo. It looks fantastic. This is Ketsuko from Agritsuko. I hope I said that right too. Super dope tattoo. This has got to be the best one I've seen this session, by far. And I know this isn't a realistic tattoo, and I think we've judged a lot of those this session. And this may look like a simple color tattoo, but it's really not. This is why I think traditional tattoos are also some of the hardest tattoos you can do. When doing something like this, it's very easy to see the mistakes and blowouts and flares and things like that. If you mess up, you're gonna see it. Let's break it down. The outline is exceptional. The line weight that you have in the scarf and the shirt and the border of the cat is money. The little line weight that you have on the inside of the ears, the inside of the rainbow, again, on point. The coloring is wall-to-wall color. I don't see any open holidays or anything like that. It's a good job. So, I mean, I'm super impressed so far. And I'm trying to find something bad with it, so I don't know. I think you got me. I love the little green splash in the back. The little hearts around it are cute. The rainbow is on point. Okay, I've got maybe one thing to say. You've got a nice thick blue outline around the top of the rainbow. On the bottom of the rainbow, there's a thinner pink outline. It doesn't look bad how it sits, but I think I'll be curious to see what it looks like with a thicker pink outline at the bottom of that rainbow. I'm nitpicking here. I feel like a little bit of that yellow kind of got, you know, a little caught up between those hearts, but I mean, you've got all those outlines around in there, and then you've got yellow, which is also one of the toughest colors to work with, so I'm gonna let that slide. If we zoom in onto their left eye, you got a little bit out of the lines with the outline, maybe a little loose on the eyes, but that's not something I would normally even call out. But since these tattoos have to be so perfect, it's just that, you know, you see those things. Like I said, I'm nitpicking. Wonderful work, Sia. I mean, so you really outdid yourself on this one. Home run, knocked it out of the park. Right on, Sia. Thank you so much for sending that in. All right, that's going to be it for this episode. Thank you guys so much for sending in your work. If you want me to critique your work, send it to ponycritiques@gmail.com, and maybe we'll see it on a future episode. Don't forget to hit that notification bell, and please subscribe. Check out the artist's work that I critiqued today, and check out these videos. Until next time.